In this week's Closer Look, the controversy surrounding Brian Williams. The NBC anchor has apologized and taken himself off the air after veterans called him out for falsely claiming his helicopter was hit by a rocket during the Iraq War. NBC has also launched an internal investigation, and the episode has sparked a vigorous debate on social media and in newsrooms, where those of us who are both colleagues and competitors are wrestling with the implications. ABC's David Wright starts us off.
It has become painfully apparent to me that I am now too much a part of the news due to my actions. So said a personal note from Brian Williams posted on the NBC News website. The anchor deciding to take himself off the broadcast for the next several days.
I made a mistake in recalling the events of 12 years ago.
That decision after an extraordinary mea culpa this past week.
I want to apologize. I said I was traveling in an aircraft that was hit by RPG fire. I was instead in a following aircraft.
Apologizing for a segment broadcast on NBC Nightly News the previous week.
The story actually started with a terrible moment a dozen years back during the invasion of Iraq, when the helicopter we were traveling in was forced down after being hit by an RPG.
In that story, Williams paid tribute to a soldier who, he said, saved his life after a close call during the invasion of Iraq. NBC posted the story to Facebook, and soldiers on the helicopter struck by a rocket-propelled grenade called Williams out. Sorry, dude, I don't remember you being on my aircraft, flight engineer Lance Reynolds wrote. I do remember you walking up about an hour after we landed to ask what had happened. Door gunner Mike O'Keefe called Williams a liar. Williams then admitted he must have misremembered. The incident has exposed him to ridicule. On Twitter, people are posting parodies. Brian Williams at the moon landing. Brian Williams at Gettysburg. Brian Williams with the Ten Commandments. Hashtag Brian Williams misremembers. Now, Williams' reporting and anecdotes from Hurricane Katrina have come under scrutiny, too. So NBC News has launched an internal investigation. The news division president telling the staff, we are working on what the best next steps are. But in his own statement, Williams made it clear he plans to come back. For this week, David Wright, ABC News, New York.
Let's talk about this now with our media experts, Liz Spade, editor and publisher of the Columbia Journalism Review, and David Folkenflik, the media correspondent and critic at NPR. And Liz, let me begin with you. We've now seen Brian Williams put himself on the bench for a few days. He says NBC investigating. Are those the right moves, and what needs to happen now?
I think it's the right move. I think it's a few days late. I would have said that the network and Brian Williams should have made a decision that they would have done this earlier when this first erupted. I think the right move next, actually, is for the network to have this investigation that they've started be done outside. I don't think that there's going to be enough credibility that gets attached to that kind of an investigation when the people doing it no doubt have personal connections, personal relationships with Brian Williams. They work for a network who had that has a lot at stake. That would be my recommendation.
And some reports this morning that maybe NBC had known about this in the past. And that is what Dave Folkenflik, what CBS did when Dan Rather got into those questions, had those questions about the reporting on George W. Bush's draft record. They brought in an outside panel to investigate.
Well, and let's be clear, they did that after Dan Rather had used his evening newscast, I think quite disingenuously, to protect and defend his now completely discredited report. I think that actually is ultimately what cost Rather his job, was the way in which he handled it. We learned it time and time again. It's not that journalists shouldn't be thought of as authoritative, but when they fall short, and they often do, it's how they deal with it that really, I think, they're judged
the
in the public
realm. Same
standard
that journalists use for politicians.
Absolutely.
And Elizabeth, does it make any difference, though, that for most of these exaggerations, tall tales, lies, whatever you want to call them, we're on shows that were not his own show, weren't the reporting. It was him talking about his reporting.
Yeah. I don't know that matters to the public. I think that this whole incident is part of the cult of personality in a way that has taken over the media, not just broadcast, but now, you know, you could have a blogger or a star reporter whose name is almost as important to the public as the media brand that they work for. And so he is a personification of that to the public. His public integrity is on display in whichever venue I think that he's in.
So what are the next best steps?
Well, right now, I think that you've seen this thing that they called it a review inside NBC News. And I think it's interesting you talk about it as an investigation. I'm not sure internally at NBC they have gotten to that point emotionally or mentally. There's been no promise of disclosure publicly of what the findings are. Yeah. There's been a promise of telling the staff and presumably the public what the next steps will be. And that really, what they're really signaling is whether or not Brian Williams comes back behind the anchor's desk. But I think they need to keep faith with the public. I think they need to be very transparent. If Brian Williams wants to go on and rebuild his career after this tough blow to his credibility, he's been there more than two decades, perhaps he deserves the chance. He needs to make good, and the network needs to make good on what happened, what went wrong, and what they're going to do going forward.
Okay, Dave Folkenflik, Liz Spade, thanks very much.
Thank you.